Okay, hi guys. So this video is to show you how to explain the antenna patterns, okay, and their meaning. Okay, so I will show you something like this. So this one is from Cisco. Okay, this is the one of the article from them, the white paper. So you just scroll here. Okay, I will tell you like how we're going to understand the data and the file, okay, in CST and radiation pattern. So previously I show you guys the Cartesian, the 1D plot, right? Okay. And 2D, okay. Oh, but in CST they call 1D polar, but actually this one is like looks like 2D, okay. And we'll show you like how the radiation pattern of omnidirectional and directional antenna, okay. And then how to like view it, okay. So let's say we have this part, okay. So dipole antenna and 3D radiation pattern, okay. Azimuth plan and elevation plan, okay. The pattern. So it's something like, its meaning actually is like something like this. Okay, so for azimuth, right, you need to cut like horizontal. Okay, that means they will cut half here, the y axis here. And then for the elevation, right, they will cut like here, vertical. Okay, that means they call this like H plane, and then this one is like E plane. Okay, so you will have something like this. Okay, how to get like azimuth plane, right, is something like you cut half like horizontal. And then you will get a round shape if you view from the top. Okay. And then how to get like elevation plan pattern? That means you cut like vertical from here, from Z, and then you cut down like half here. Okay. And then you only saw like half. Okay. So let's go to CST, right? So CST here is like they will show you. Okay. You go to the file and then help, and then you find dipole. When dipole, they have a lot, so you actually can just use this one, the dipole antenna, and then transient solver, because we use a time domain solver. Okay, and then once you run it, you will have something like this. Okay, so remember to simulate the far field. Okay, sometimes the result is not in good far field, so you need to simulate it, and then you will get something like this. Okay, this one is like too big for you to view it. Okay, because the gain is the log magnitude. Okay, so we can just go to properties, and then we change the log to like maybe 6 dB is enough. This one too thin, maybe we make it like 15. Okay, we make it like 9. Okay, 9 looks good. Okay, so you can see something like this. Okay, so it looks like the file like this, right? So how to see view on azimuth and elevation. So we will go for in the 1D, right? Okay, we call 1D a 1D polar. Okay, so we apply it 90 degree of the phi. That means theta, right? That means theta is something like this. So always remember the phi will be here and then theta on the top for this case. So 90 degree, that means they will go 90 degree here. Okay, 90 degree here. They will move like turn 90 degree here, and then they will cut half. Okay, let's apply. You will have something like this. Okay, so still consider big, right? So you can just like click on linear so you can have better view. Okay, so you will have something like this. So it looks like this. Okay, okay, or I make it like the plot is like, okay, it's linear, so maybe we make it like 6. Okay, something like this. So you actually, it looks like this. Okay, so when you go here, right, when you click on phi, you will get 90 something like this. So when you click on phi, 90 degree of the theta, okay, so you apply, you will get a round shape here. Okay, so you can review on of their gain as well. So this one is their gain, so it's 2.2 dB, and you can go for like theta also should be 2.2. Okay, okay, why this mean? Why is this mean? This is like 2.2 is mean here, 2.2. Okay, if you zoom in here, actually it's 2.2, you can put the marker. Okay, so it's 2.2 here. Okay, same as this one, fine. Also, you will get like 2.2 here. Okay, 2.2. Okay, how are we going to cut from the 3D? So let me show you the 3D. You apply it, so you will have something like this, right? Okay, so to cut like, for the this one, azimuth. Okay, so you need to cut like horizontal. Okay, so we need to cut the horizontal here. So you can see, right, the phi is here. Okay, horizontal phi is here. Okay, and then the theta is here. Okay, to cut it half, right, okay, we actually need to, like, you can see, like, theta actually is this round shape. Okay, so we need to cut half of this. Okay, that means we only need, like, the half of the circle. Okay, so we just put, like, 90 degrees here. That means, right, your theta will be go this side, 90 degrees. Oh no, it means like starting at 90 degrees. That means you will start at 90 degrees here because 0 is here, right? So you go here, is starting 90 degrees here, and then go until 100 degrees, 180. So 0 to here is 180. Okay, so from here 90 to 180, and then you make a circle, right? Okay, a circle, then you will have a base here. Okay, so that means, right, from here and here, you don't have any, like, the thickness going up to the theta side. That means the z-axis. Okay, let me apply. Can you see? Something like this. So you will get, like, azimuth. Okay, so it's something like this. When azimuth, right, is something like you view on the top. So when you want to view on the top, you can see something like this. When you want to view on the top, right, the phi will be going up, and then the theta will be front here. So why front here? Because just now phi is here, right, this side. So you can see something like this. The phi now is on top, and then your theta is here. That means, right, you will go turn 90 degrees this side, 90 degrees. Okay. So 90 degrees this side is a circle. So when you go back to the 1D, right, you apply phi is on the top here, and then you move the theta to 90 from here to here. Okay. From this side into the center, because 90 degrees, so you apply, you will get the circle exactly the same. Okay, so we can view the result. So the result is 2.2 dB, right? So you can view it like 3D. Okay, they also get almost similar, 2.2, okay, because that one is like they round up, so you get 2.2 as well. Okay, so now you're going to look at the theta and then 90 degrees. Okay, you will cut like this one, this side. That means you will cut vertical, then you get elevation plane pattern. So something like this. So you go like 3D here. Okay, so this one you go back to 0. And then phi you need to put like 90. And then this one need to be like 270. Why? Because here show 90. Oops. And here show 270. Okay, so you just apply. Then you will get something like this. But actually, we need to move up first. Okay, again. From the first is something like this. Right? It's like a donut. And then you need to cut it vertically. Okay, so it's like 90 to 270. Okay, so you will have something like this. But when you move to 90, right? That means, right? Something like this. Start at 90 and then 270. So you know, like a circle. So here is 0 degree, here is 90 degree, here is 180, and then behind here is 270, and then come back is 360, right? So starting from 90 until 270, that means, right, starting from 90 until behind here to 270, they have only the result they will plot. Okay, that means 270 until 360, they won't plot it. Okay, that's why you here it's empty. That means, right, it's like cut vertical. Okay, so you, when your this one is like 90, right, so if you want to view, right, you just move like 90 degrees here. So you can, you see 90 degrees here. So now you can see you as exactly same as your polar here. Okay, so if you make it linear, yeah, you can see it like this. Okay, so I think we can make like 3D apply. Yeah, something like this. Okay, so exactly the same. So the result is like 1.6 here. No, oh, it's linear now. Okay, so 1.6 is linear. Okay, gain. So you go back to polar, should we get 1.6 as well. Okay, and then the 1.6, that means, right, actually is from this side, the maximum power here. Okay, 1.6. That's why you can see the red color here, 1.66. Okay, next. So we're done for the dipole. Okay, so now you know how to view like azimuth and then like elevation plan. Okay, so remember the default is this one is like 0, this one is like 360. Okay, or you can just like untick this one. Let's say I have like 90, right, and then 270. Okay, so if you untick this one, you will get the full 3D as well. Okay, so I will show you something like this to understand how the plot is looks like. Okay, let's say just now, right, we have 360 here. Okay, so when we apply, that means, right, 90 degree, you can play around this one. So the phi is here, right? So they remove 90 degree, that means here and here is empty because we're starting from 90 degree until 360. So if I remove this one to change this one to 180, that means 90 degree here, they will go until this side. Okay, so they will have only this side. So we just click on apply, you have this side. Okay, so you can see. Okay, so if you want to like maybe 0 until 180, then you will get half because 0 here until 180 here. Okay, so this one is how it looks like for the plot for the phi. So for theta, okay, so theta is something like this. From the top right, they go from here. Okay, let's say I just want the top donut here and then the bottom one we remove. That means right, your 0 degree is here. You go until here is 90. That means we start from 0 until 90. Okay, and then we just make a turn because 360, right, define the turn drawing the circle. That means right, you will get the full length here. That's why when you see the theta and phi, right, this one is like only like until 180 and then this one is like 360. Why? Because from here you just need to draw like half and then you make a circle, then it's a sphere. Okay, so let's apply. You can see only half on top here. So if you like 45 degree, that means your this one until 45 here. Okay, then others they remove, that means no red color here. So you just apply, then you can see it's until 45. Why become bigger? Because actually it's still the same. Okay, they just like zoom in. Okay, because your result value here is different as well. So again, 90 is the maximum. So it's 166. After that, when you do it like 45, right, they actually is something like this. Okay, apply, then they will cut. Yeah, become small. But view from here, you can see like already empty. Okay, this side. So it's like 45 degree, something like this. 45. Okay, this is the how you are going to play around with this. Okay, so next we will go for the another one will be the horn antenna. Okay, so this one is the same. You just cut half, you will see from the top, you will get this. And then if you cut vertical, the elevation, then you will see like they have two like side look here, right, because of this. Okay, so next we go for like maybe horn antenna. So yeah, okay, so again for the like the directional antenna, right, they have slightly different. Okay, so you only can play around with you won't cut like half like horizontal here because it won't show anything. You will cut like azimuth, that means it's like your node. Okay, so this one will be in your node, is something like this. Okay, so the azimuth cut, right, so let's say you have a directional, okay, you will cut like horizontal, then they will become like this, and vertical here, and then they will become like this. Okay, so you will show this in CST, how it looks like. So actually you won't get like, if you cut half here, like, actually you will see a circle as well. Okay, but we have no point to see that because our power is here. It's different from dipole. Okay, dipole is like, they have like whole power in this side, and like vertical also the same, like when we cut it half, okay, when they also the same have here the power. That means right, something like when you cut half, let's say 180 here, and then here is like 90. Okay, you get like full power also. okay, this side. And then when you cut like this side, 190 to 270, okay, you're also getting the full power from the side, so you can see the gain is the same. But for directional, it's different. The only one directional is like one direction is full power. Okay, so we will go for like, let's say we choose like our horn antenna. Okay, so we have this. Okay, we choose a horn antenna because the direction is almost similar as directional antenna, right? Okay, so we will cut azimuth and elevation. So let's say you just go to the example, you can find the circular horn. Okay, just like type on your horn here. You have like circular horn and horn antenna. I use both. So we can like analyze the result. So let's say we have a circular horn here. Then you just simulate the far field. Then you get your far field here. Okay. Let's say you have a far field now. It's like this. So this is your horn and then your far field. Okay, so you will have something like this. Okay, your theta and your phi. So let's say we just look at the 1D polar first. 1D polar here, apply phi. So when you choose like 90 degree phi, right, you will see like really low power, negative 9.23 dB for the gain. And then the theta is direction like this. Okay, for theta and phi 90, right, okay, so you can see from here 3D plot. Okay, something like this. Theta is fixed and then 90 degree. Okay, so we will cut half. Okay, let's talk about this first. So still remember 1D plot, okay, for theta and 90 degree. Okay, so you have 90 degree here and phi 270. So 3D 90 degree, oops, not this one, 90 degree here, 270. So you just apply for 3D. So that means right, you have like cut half, okay, vertical, okay, something like this. Something like this, elevation plan, okay. So you will have, so you need to move 90, right? So now you are like the phi move 90, so you have something like this, okay. So remember when you choose theta and then 90 degree here, that means your phi need to move like 90 and then your theta is here. So you can view from 1D plot, okay, you will get like similar drawing. Okay, can you see it? Yeah, and then the gain is like 14.1. Okay, so let's go back and then check on here. Yeah, 14.1. Okay, so you get exactly the same. Okay, so let's say we do same as just now the dipole, right? Okay, let's say we do something like this. 90 degree for phi. Okay, you get something like this. So actually it's like very low power. We don't look for this here, this side, because in 3D, right, you will have something like this. 0, 360, okay, and then here will be 90, like just now the polar setting, right? So that means, right, you will cut half of your horn. Okay, something like this. Something like this one, okay. Phi will be on the top, okay. And then the theta will move 90 degrees to this side. Okay, so you will get something like this. So if I not transparent the far field, so you will get something like this. So I make it linear, much easy to view. Okay, so you will have something like this. Really low power. Okay, so in the middle for this. That means right, phi on the top. Okay, the theta is here, right? So you move 90 degrees to view from here. Okay, because we make it like this. Phi 90 degree, so phi 90 degree here, so you have very low power, and then 3D we make it like 90 and then something like this. Okay, so you can see the dB is 0.3191. okay, it's different, okay, because we actually don't want to view for this side. Okay, so what we want to is like the azimuth, right? So azimuth will be something like this. Okay, let's say for the horn, right? Okay, just now it's like 0 here. We apply, so you have like we untick this one for better view. Okay, something like this. Okay, so let's say you want to cut like half elevation, right? So it's 90 and 270 here. So you have this. Okay, so now you have vertical here. Okay, so you want to cut another half is from this side. Okay, without the, maybe the, without the y-axis here. Okay, so that means now it's like z and y plane. Okay, so you can see it's like z and y only. Okay, the x here don't have anything. So now you need to z and x plane. That means the y get nothing. So you can do it like, so you know, right, from here is 0, 90 and 180. So now you are like 90 to 270 behind here. So I want to make it like azimuth, right? So another side is like 180 to 360. So I make it like 180, 360. So I apply. So I get something like this. So I made it transparent, maybe much easier to view. Okay, so you can see it's like half. It's like only at a Y plane without anything here. Okay, they only have Z and X. Okay, that means if you view from here, you will get azimuth. That means you cut like one is like vertical, one is like horizontal. Okay, so if you have something like this, okay, let's say I have a horn like this. Let's say I now, something like this one. Okay, so now I, let's say I cut horizontal. Okay, and then if I want to cut like elevation, then 90 to 270, apply. You can see. Okay, again 180 to 360, something like this. Yeah, so this one is like for directional, you, how you cut it for like elevation and azimuth. Okay, so done for this. Okay, and then one thing is the same gain you will get, because for horn antenna, right? Okay, you from here and this side azimuth, because your main loop here, the middle is the same. Okay, you just like cut vertical and horizontal. So let's try again. So this one is horizontal azimuth. Okay, now we try like the elevation. So this one we can do it like 270. Okay, so you can see the gain is the same. Okay, so done for the horn, right? So we go for another. So make it faster for this kind of like normal horn. Okay, so the for the square horn, something like this, right? So we make it like we made it linear, so easy to view, or we can just change the dB. Okay, so make it like 15 maybe. Okay, this one consider better. So let's go back to the, okay, this one we change to gain. Okay, so now we already know, right? So the theta will on top, and then we will have phi. So let's say something like this. Okay, this one is not the one, because they will have the circle like, oh, okay, theta phi, this is what we want. Okay, so you can see from here. And then for the phi, this is not what we want, because they cut horizontal, something like this. So I will show you, it's like apply. Okay, that means they will cut half here, the horizontal. That means you will get something like this side. So this is not what we want. So let's say you cut it half like this. So you get something that looks like butterfly here, okay, because they cut half on the middle, so you just left like something like this. Okay, so you will change like, let's say theta, right? Just now it's phi, so phi will be something like this. You move around, and then phi will be something like here, okay. Then you will make it like 90 degrees here, okay. Then just apply. Okay, so looks like this, right? But actually, if you put, choose on linear, you'll see the butterfly. Okay, so it's similar as this one, 1D. Okay, this one. Okay, so this is not what you want. So what you want is just on 3D. So we make it like 0 here. And then we apply again. So we need to cut it half like azimuth, so something like this. Okay. Okay, so the coordinate should be something like this. The phi will be facing here. Okay, the theta will be this side. So you make it like 90 to 270. Okay, so you will get, I mean, make it transparent. Okay, you will get something like this. Okay, the half like vertical. Okay, the elevation. So if I want to make it like horizontal, we will make it like 90. So we change this to 180 to 360. So we just click on apply. So you can see like vertical and horizontal. Okay, so how are we going to view it like something like these two azimuth and elevation in CST? So it's something like you click on here, 1P, right? Okay, so theta is no problem for this. Okay, so you will have the view something like this. Okay, for azimuth, this one is for elevation. Okay, for azimuth, you can just choose like 5, and then this one change to 0. Oops, not this one. Oh, okay, nothing to do with the 5 because it doesn't change anything in theta this side. So we go to theta, and then you can make it like 180, okay, or 0. So you can see is they have another direction. Okay, so if you make it like 290, okay, you can slightly see the difference here this side. So apply. Okay, so you can slightly see the difference. So you can also view from here, right? The azimuth is like slightly different. Okay, and the elevation. Okay, because they cut on this side and this side. So you can see the side look is different. Horizontal and vertical. So again, so something like this one, because this one is 90 and then this one is 180. Why 180? Because we changed this one to 180. So apply again, so we get something like this. Okay, so let's show again. It's like we go to 3D, apply, so 180, something like this. So you view from top, you will get actually something like this, 180. Okay, or we can make it like this. So let me view for you is something like this. Okay, so now you have like theta is fixed. Okay, so theta is fixed now, and then you just click on apply, right? So then it's 180, so you get something like this. It's like half right. Okay, like horizontal, and then another one is like you make it like 1D and then cut it like 90. Okay. Okay, you will get elevation. So from here 3D, you need to like 90 here. Okay, so cut another half is like when 90, you need to change to 270. So you will get another half here. Okay, so this is how it's shown. That's why this one is looks like the 1D polar for elevation. Okay. Okay, so next is like we go back to our helical antenna. Okay, the helix antenna, then we have the polarization, like something like this. So we use back the concept. So we have theta here and phi here. So now we're going to check is like when we cut half, okay, and another half, how it looks like. So let's start is like click on properties, and then we make it like 15, much easy to view. Okay, the size, okay, something like this. Okay, then we're going to choose is like, so it's like vertical antenna, right? Okay, so we were going to do is like 90 here and 270. So we apply, it will cut half. Okay, so we are half here. Okay, it's like vertical. Okay, so another half is like horizontal is 180 and make it like 360. Okay, so you can see another half is horizontal. Okay, so if we make it like something like this, okay, so this is horizontal and then this one is vertical. Okay, so this is how it looks like. Okay, so we also can see the plan, how it looks like. It's like, okay, let's say now I'm going to do is like 90 to 270, right? So it's actually like they already cut half. So we just move it like elevation. We move it like 90 because you cut 90, right? So you move 90 here so you can view the full from 100, from the 90 here to 270. This side. Okay, so the 3D, the 2D view should be something like this. Okay, and then you can see it's in the middle. Okay, so it's something like this. So let's try it. Phi, theta, 90. You just click on apply. See, exactly almost the same. So another one, you can choose like 0, 180. Okay, they were slightly different. Okay, something like this. So we can go for 3D. Now we know it's like 180, right? So 180 until 360. So we just click on apply. So we just move it back. So you will have, okay, so you have something here, right? Okay, something here and somewhere like curve here. So we view back the 1D. Okay, so you have something here and the curve here. Okay, so this is how it looks like. Okay. Okay, so directional antenna, right? If you use like the polar one and the dipole one, let's see, just not a dipole, it's something like this, right? This one is 90 degree. Okay, so you will get actually something like a circle here. Okay, something like circle here because your vertical antenna, right? Helical antenna already changed to this direction. That means, right? Let me make it zero first. Okay, it's something like this. Your vertical antenna, the main have been like something like this, the phi on the top, okay, and your theta is in this side. Okay, so I will show you how it looks like. So they will remove the circle, it's like you made it like 90, right? Just now, okay, 90. So we're going to change this to 90 here, the theta. So theta 90, okay, so you can see it's become bigger, something like this, but we can make it like linear. So you can view the curve is curve here and bit here. So we make it like back to polar. You see exactly the same. Okay. Why something like this is like, okay, so you can see, you can play around like this. So actually, right, you can view from, okay, again. So this one is like the view from here, right? So your direction for your helical is this side. So in polar also the same, something like this. Okay, so this one is your this. Okay, so let me show you something like this. Why this happened is something like when you play around the theta, right? So they mean theta, they cutting going down. So it's mean something like this. So if I start from zero, okay, they will have full directional. Okay, so if I theta like remove like 10, so you will remove here 10. That means, right, they are starting from 10 here. Only they draw 180. Okay, so I apply. So you can see the red color here is missing. Okay, they start 10 here. And then let's say I start like 20, 30. Okay, so you can see they're starting from here, this side. They mean here and here, nothing. Because here, drawing here. Okay, so and like 45. Okay, and then if I make it like 17. So you see, can smaller and smaller because it starts at 70 here. If I make it like 90, that means they start from 90 here. Okay, theta 0 until 90 here. Okay, so that means, right, okay, they only draw this circle at the bottom. So you can see actually only the bottom, this side. On the top here, 0 until 90, they doesn't have anything. They only have like 90 until 180. Okay, 90 until 180, then they draw a circle. That's why this plan on the top, the plan here is they don't have anything. So if I make it like 0 to 90, you can see like the bottom part they don't have, only they have the plan on the top. So we just click on apply. Okay, so you can see from here they have nothing. Okay, you can see like bottom side have nothing. So if I make it back, it's like if I add something, maybe 150. You can see the bottom side, they will add something. Okay, yeah. So this is how you're going to understand the radiation pattern in CST and the drawing. Okay, so what is the relationship between 2D and 3D azimuth and iteration? Okay, so yeah, if you have any question about this, yeah, you can ask me in the class. Okay, so yeah, just try to play around and then looks how it looks like. Okay, so thanks guys.